Hey guys, how's it going? It's Fishy Fish here coming at you with a brand new episode of Nothing Harder. If you don't know what the show's about, basically, I'm playing the classic mode on 9.0 difficulty, also known as Nothing Harder, with every single character in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. And today we have Ike, which was suggested by the lovely people popping on screen now. And Ike is a really interesting character, and Ike's actually a character that I've done for the Amiibo tournament. So I have had some experience with Ike, playing a lot with him, considering that, you know, it takes you about 2 hours to train each character to fit level 50 on the Amiibo tournament. So I have had quite an experience, and it may be some kind of trend, the fact that I did Rosalina last time, but not really. I just did what people suggest, and people suggested Ike this time. I actually had a lot of difficulty doing with Ike for whatever reason. It's actually the only character that I've completed it in the 3DS version, the 9.0 difficulty on the 3DS version with. I haven't played too much of 9.0 on the 3DS, but he is the only character I've actually completed it with. So I thought it would be a breeze, but for some reason, I really failed a lot on this. And maybe it's because I haven't been doing a lot of Nothing Harders, which I'll explain about in a bit. But I haven't been doing a lot more recently. But still, like, I didn't think it'd take me 20 tries or something like that. I can't remember exactly how many, but in the fail compilation, it'll keep track and you'll see how many it did. And it's not one or two, it is like in the tens. I think maybe 13 sounds about right. That's a number I'm thinking of off the top of my head. So, what happened was, the reason why there wasn't one last week was because I was going away. I was away this current week. So this week, where the most recent Amiibo tournament and like the Almar with War Crime one, I was away this week because I was just away. So I wanted to re-record everything, and as I was recording Ike, I just kept on failing way too much. And this was the night before I was leaving too, so I needed to get all my footage recorded this night. I was so tired. It was like midnight at this point, and Ike was still not done. And so I kind of said, you know what, I'll put him aside for now, and I'll get all recorded done for the Amiibo tournament, because that's what I wanted to prioritize on. Sorry, guys, if you are here for Nothing Harder, and I'm prioritizing on the Amiibo tournament, but they do take a lot more work, so and a lot more people do watch them as well, so I do prioritize them rather than Nothing Harder. But, so I really wanted to get that video done because I do enjoy making them a lot too. So I really want to get all the footage done so I could actually do it while I was away. So basically, the reason why this didn't come out was because I had one day to record all the footage and I kept on losing. So it is the sad fact, the fact that I didn't manage to do it, but, you know, sorry about that. Don't worry about next week, Lucas is coming, because I'm not going to bother, like, you know, some people suggest it, because that is coming next, and it's actually going to be an early episode. I'm not sure at this point right now whether I actually will do, not just Lucas, but Lucas and the next day one, or will that count for the week? Anyway, I'm talking a lot about stuff that is very current, and if you're watching this in the future, I'm very sorry, but here we go. Here's Ike. Ike's a really interesting character because he has a lot of really cool moves. I mean, he is slow, and he doesn't have that great aerial, I find. Like, his moves all come out really slow, a lot slower than I wish they did. So he's not really my favorite character, but because he was the first character that I actually did in Amiibo tournament, and make sure you guys check out that video if you don't know what I'm talking about. He was the first character. Oh, come on, I saw that coming too. This is when I was really frustrated. I got 87%. He meant zero. But I was, I considered him, like, maybe my best character at one point, because I was doing really well with him in the Amiibo tournament. But soon after, I realized that was just because I spent so much time on him. It was ridiculous. So, here he is now, and I failed to use his counter a lot, which is a big mistake, because his counter is really powerful. See, Marth just got me with his counter right there. He's actually kind of spamming his counter now. Not really spamming, but like using it way too much. Like, again, see there, it's annoying. But don't worry, because the final smash is here to save the day. As long as Marth doesn't get it. Spoiler alert, I think I may know what happens here. So get him with a good up smash, not that it matters. And boom, final smash. Come on, get over here, Marth. Yep, there you're stuck. The stage is frozen, and here we go. So yeah, I really like, I'm not saying I dislike Ike, but he's not my favorite character, obviously. Like, I prefer him over other characters, I can't think of any right now, But I prefer him over some characters, but he's definitely... No offense to any Ike maids or anyone who loves Ike, but he's not... You know, I'm not going to play much with him. So, I definitely respect him, and he's a cool character. He definitely can, he has a lot of cool moves and stuff to do. Oh, and by the way, this is the beginning of destruction right here. My team of Luigi, Game & Watch, and Mewtwo, destruction. Anyway, sorry to go off there, but... So, that's my opinion. Ike has some really cool tools and moves and stuff that are... That really covers a lot of bases, and it's exactly what you need. So anyway, as you're going to see my teammate destroy us, we're going to be launching some questions, and I really want to encourage you guys to ask us a lot of questions, because I love answering them, because I need questions to answer. So we have a few questions today, and we're going to go and answer them. Also, guys, forgot to mention that if you were wondering why there's been less Melting Hardens as well, is because we're only doing one a week now, and that's going to be every Monday. So, and then Wednesdays is now going to be a random video, which, that's just the way it is. That's my schedule. Anyway, we're going to do some questions. If you don't know what questions is, this is the time to answer and ask any questions you would like. They can be any questions at all. They don't have to be video game or Smash Bros. Related even. They can be any question you like. So the first question comes from Maxwell Eng, whose picture is the guy, the aliens guy, right here. But his question is, Fishy, have you ever played Poke Park Wii? Now, I've always really wanted to play Poke Park Wii. It seems like a really cool game, because it's like, it's a collection of mini-games, I believe, but unfortunately, I have never played. I don't know how well it's done, to be honest, because I remember look at that, Robin get destroyed. But I really wanted to play it, and I've actually tried to play it multiple times, I've never actually got it, never played it. Like, I've tried to get it, like, there's two of them as well. It's always been a game I've really wanted to play, and like, start a full campaign and just go for it, but I've never actually had the chance or time. So it's really a game that I really want to play, and I definitely do not count it out, because again, I have wanted to play this game for a while. Like, it's a weird history about trying to play this game. But yes, I have not played Poke Park Wii, but I really want to play it. Thanks, Max Maxwell, for that question. So the next question comes from Dustin Davis. This is a really interesting question. And he says that, do you think Ice Climbers and Rosalina are kind of similarly programmed? Similar, yes, in terms of the fact that you're technically controlling two characters. Ice Climbers, though, you don't separate. You are essentially playing as one character with someone who's following you and copying your moves. That's the Ice Climbers. Whereas with Rosalina and Luma, you are actually controlling two characters. At the same time, so there are obviously differences, that goes without saying, but it's just the differences are it is pretty different. The fact that, you know, Rosalina and Luma, you can like send Luma off and then destroy them from a distance. Watch, I love that feature. That's a really cool thing you can do, but you couldn't really do with Ice Climbers. And I believe if you even got too far away from Nana, it's completely AI controlled. You can't control her from a distance. I can't remember exactly if that's true, but maybe. So, I think they are similarly programmed, but they're very different characters. If they were to bring the Ice Climbers back, they would still be entirely different characters. So, they're similarly programmed. I'm not sure what you mean by that, but similarly programmed, very similar concept where you control two characters. Thanks, Dustin, for that question. As we're going on to the final Crazy Hand battle, this last question comes from Donnie Fisto, and his question is, what do you expect to see in Pikmin 4? If anything, do you plan on seeing any returning characters? If so, say which characters and explain why. So, man, I would love to see Pikmin 4, and as I even said before, that I'm limiting myself to one Pikmin question because I could talk about it forever, but Pikmin 4, what do I expect to see in Pikmin 4? I don't even know what to say what I expect in Pikmin 4. Pikmin 4, I had a theory a while ago that, you know, it would be cool to see you be able to combine Pikmin. So, like, you had a mix thing where you can take a red and a yellow and you make whatever color that is. Green, maybe? So you can make green Pikmin from yellow and reds and stuff like that. And, like, they're, like, much powerful or something like that. And, like, use this different thing. I was thinking to see that, but obviously that's not going to happen. So I do prefer the formula. I would like to see, I want to see the combined onion return, and what else? But character-wise, anything, any returning characters. Character-wise, I definitely hope we see a continuation of Olimar and Louis. So I want to know what's going on in Hakutate. Come on, like, and I want to see the President as well. Like, President was one of the funniest characters to play as. I don't know for what reason, but he was completely absent in Pikmin 3. And also in Smash Bros. 2, it's not even a trophy for him. He was a playable character, come on! They had two Olimar trophies, and using his alt in the Space Explorer section. But they didn't even have a President. That's just crazy. So I really hope he comes back, so I wanted to hear the President, how he's running Hakutate with, like, maybe while they've got all their money or something, something goes wrong that causes them, like, maybe it's come like a competition to go to the planet or something, because the secret's out that they've got. But anyway, I'm not entirely sure. That's what I would want to see. Regardless, if it's more Pikmin, I am down for it. If there's more Pikmin types, if there's more Pikmin gameplay, I will play it to completion. Maybe have a series, who knows? Maybe at E3 they'll announce some Pikmin 2, who knows? I can hope, right? I can hope. Sorry, I really like Pikmin. So, that's all I can say, and thanks Donnie for the question. And we're done with that. So, as Fishy over here, the Ike, starts taking on Master Shadow, things are getting serious. I've actually died multiple times at the Master Shadow section. This was the first recording I actually got to the Master Fortress with. Excuse me. So, this is my first recording I actually got to the Master Fortress, and, you know, who knows, will I do it, will I not? It's anyone's guess. You can make an educated guess here, but I did manage to take out the Master Shadow, and it is over, but no, it is not. Master Fortress is here. So, I did actually die a few times on the Master Shadow, which was kind of embarrassing, because I never normally do. I generally kind of brush that off. That may be why I died from it, because I didn't take it seriously. Oh my gosh. Sorry, I yawned there. I didn't really take it seriously. That might be the reason why I died there twice, I think. You'll see in the end. But also, we're going to go on here as I try to take that guy out, but he's too powerful. So I just ignore him. Just run away. Again, a huge tip with a lot of these guys. Running away is a very good strategy. I just take out these, oh no, I forgot their names. I just take these guys out because they are really annoying and they can shoot through walls too. So you can't hide and you can't be safe. So it is, it can be tricky to get out of their way sometimes and avoid taking damage. So I find it's useful just to, here, this is really funny. Just watch, I just, I just find them extremely annoying and I just wanted to get rid of them because they're just in the way and they can easily not be in the way if I just take a few seconds to knock them into the lava, which is all I really do, and sometimes just do a few flip tilts if I miss. So like that, see, just get them out of the way, no big deal. And again, just if you want to avoid dying a really awkward, embarrassing deaths, it can easily be done just by knocking these enemies out of the way and avoiding their attacks. Obviously, this all just goes without saying. Anyway, I realized also my global smash power is very high. I'm not sure this is my best game that I've done with in Nothing Harder, but I'm doing well. A 937,000. I think if I continue taking out characters, I may actually beat my high score. Anyway, that doesn't matter though because we're almost at the end, and Ike is getting really intense. The heartbeat's going, the screen is shaking. Ike is destroying 955,000, so much points. But I've got free shots on the Master Core. Although, these guys are now back, and I just got to take them out. Which is really weird, because the Plasmas actually shot me with that for once. Which doesn't happen that often. So, I was a little nervous there, because I could have gone to lava and started a chain reaction. But fortunately, I did not. And now, there's no enemies left for me to have this all alone to myself. To just do that, and take him out. Do not be to celebrate, as I fly down the screen, and that is all she wrote. Now, I remember I did this actually really quick, so I'm going to say this rather fast. You guys, thank you so much for watching this another episode of Nothing Harder. Make sure you guys click like and subscribe for more content just like this that's coming out 3 times a week on my channel. So if you enjoyed this video, leave a like and comment. It means a lot to me, and I'll leave you guys with the fail compilation. Bye, guys.